It's there, and it's very self-explanatory, and I didn't need to add any lines to it, and I felt God tell me that. We're done. Okay, we're done. So then I had the rest of the afternoon to do whatever I wanted. So that was kind of nice. Gifts are very important. How many of you guys are ready for Christmas morning to get your gifts? Really? You're that excited to give gifts Christmas morning? Okay, all right. It's really important to give gifts, isn't it? It makes you feel really good inside. And it's really nice to see how people react when they get a gift. At this time, I need the Deborah Circle people or ladies. Deborah Circle people, they're ladies. To come on up.
Or maybe just Cheryl.
I don't know if they're all coming or not. Okay. We're going to give some gifts. Or they're going to give some gifts.
We are.
Well,
first of all, I'm going to say thank you, thank you, thank you to our pastor and his family, because I believe we have all been very blessed by having them as part of our Torrey View family. Do you all agree with that? Unfortunately, it doesn't look like they're all here right now, but I do have some things for them that most of you have helped contribute to. So, Mary, you can have that. That's for you and your brother, okay? This one's for your brother.
Thank you.
I didn't open kids.
And this one's for you.
Do we need to wait till Christmas?
But you can do whenever. And this one is for the whole family.
Thank you.
So, thank you very, very much.
Two tickets to the rescue.
No, I'm not going to the rescue. Sell them on StubHub.
There's a story of a man who had a son. They were very, very close. And they shared a love for art. And they collect a lot of really important paintings. Painters, you know, like Michelangelo and Leonardo da Vinci and things like that. They collected a lot of important paintings, very valuable paintings. And when son became old enough, he decided that he was going to join the army. And of course, it was during the Vietnam conflict, and he went off to war. And he became close to a friend who was also, he was just kind of an amateur painting. And the son did so much for the guys in his army, his troop and everything else. And so his friend wanted to paint a picture of him. And so he painted a picture of him. And of course, he was not a very well-known artist. And it happened that the son died. And so when the friend was back in the States, and he wanted to go and see the father. And so he took this painting to the dad. And he gave it to the dad, and he said, I just wanted to give this to you. I want you to know how much your son meant to all of us. And he gave his life for us, you know, and helped us to keep alive during the conflict. And so when the old man died, it was made all over England and all over the United States that all of these paintings would be up for auction. So people came from all over the place to buy or to try to bid on these paintings. And so the auctioneer got up there, and he had on the podium a painting, but it was veiled. And all these people were there, you know, great art collectors and people of museums and everything else, and were there to bid on these paintings to see if we could get these paintings. And so he started the auction off. He unveiled the first picture, and it was a picture of the sun. And of course, they're all like, we don't know who that is. And, you know, let's get to the real stuff. Let's get the stuff that really matters, the most valuable stuff. Well, he said, this one has to go first. So do I have any opening bids? Well, one man said, I will bid 50 cents for this painting. Of course, it went for 50 cents. Well, the auctioneer got up and said, the auction's over with. Of course, everybody's mad, and they couldn't understand. And so finally he said, well, it's in the will that whoever got the son got everything else. And that's just the way it is with Jesus as the gift. When you've got the Son, you've got everything else. And that's what matters. When you've got what was born in a manger that, you know, nobody wanted him in their place to be born. He was looked down on when he was older. When you have him, you have everything. And that's what we want to kind of get across in our little play tonight called The Gift.
I am so glad we're on Christmas break.
Me
do you want to stay at my house tomorrow night?
Sounds great. Want me to bring the ladies' transporter, Booby?
No, I think we're good without it. I got the list of Super Smash Brothers and enough games. I mean, enough controllers so we can all play. Do you want us to bring anything else?
You can bring me an expensive Christmas gift.
Yeah, right. My presents should be enough. Get it? Presents? I'm a pretty valuable gift, but I won't make you pay to spend time with me.
And bring me something too, but it doesn't have to be expensive. You really want me to give you a gift? Just tell me what you want and I'll give it to you.
Bring me something really special. And cost a lot of money and will make me the happiest person on earth. Do you think you can do that?
Yeah, and bring me something.
And bring me something too.
Okay, I'll see you all tomorrow night at 7 if your parents say it's okay. And bring a sleeping bag because no one's sleeping in my bed.
1, 2, 3, 13.
Mom showed me your Christmas list. Who do you think you are, being so compassionate, as Mom says? I think you just wrote those things so that you'd get what you really want. Don't you want a video game or an iPad? Something that makes us think you're a normal kid. You sound like you're being ready to be crowned Miss America or something. I just want world peace. You are such a weird little brother. I hope Mom and Dad take you up on your list and get all the presents for me.
Hey, Jenny, don't be mean to your brother like that. He was very thoughtful with his list he wrote. I wish I could give you one thing that's on that list, but only that can come from God. You need to be nicer to your brother. Remember, it's almost Christmas, and I wouldn't want you to have onions and mushrooms in your stocking, or sticks and...
I forgot the other word.
Sticks and something else in your packages. Now, go to your room and get it clean before you have to leave.
Garrett, I really liked your list. You have such a big heart. I hope God hears your prayers and gives you all those gifts. That's what Christmas is really all about. The gift that God gave us. You are wise beyond your years.
I just wish I could tell my friends about the real part about Christmas. But I don't think they will understand. All they care about is scary video games and superheroes.
Well, maybe God will give you the right opportunity to share with them. Just remember to open your heart and let God speak.
So, Mom, do you have a Christmas list?
Son, I'm too old for a Christmas list. Plus, I have everything I could ever ask for, and then some. Instead of giving material things, I think we should make a list of things we could do for others. You know, make a difference in someone's life. Like not fighting with your sister, or listening to your parents the first time.
Okay, but if you had one material gift for Christmas, what would it be?
Well, I'd have to think about that one. While I'm thinking and putting away your clothes, go in the kitchen and get a couple of those freshly baked ice cookies, and then go tease your sister about them. What would be on my list if I could get one thing? What would it be?
Here's my lifelong wish. I grown up.
what would be the best story about the birth and why it is important? I mean, the shepherds had a pretty frightening experience.
Okay, I know you guys are new at this appearing to humans thing, so let me show how it's done.
Have at it.
Yeah, sure, I went along and messed this one up. The last time I saw an angel appear to a human, a talking.
It was scary. Well, you gotta be very quiet, and you gotta sneak up on them so that way you get the full effect. And you gotta speak to them in a loud, deep voice so they know you mean business. Watch and learn. Don't be afraid! I bring you some good news!
How was that, Gabe?
Yeah, how'd you think?
Great. I think they understood. Then they're going to follow directions. Just be sure to put the order in for the North Star to be planted on the stable.
Hark, the herald angels sing.
Just be sure to put in the order for the star to be put over the stable.
I hope you all saw and heard the same thing I did. There were three of them, right?
Yep, there were three.
And they told us to follow a star?
Yep, follow the star.
Do you think we should listen? Yep, we should listen.
Well, I will tell you, I wouldn't want to have been Joseph.
Why not?
He had a huge undertaking, taking the love of his life, who was pregnant, to a town where everyone would question his intentions with her. Once the baby was born, having to raise him, a baby born to be the savior of the world, God's son, I would not want that responsibility.
Never thought of it like that.
Garrett, phone!
I mean...
This is how the birth of Jesus Christ came about. His mother Mary was pledged to be married to Joseph. But before they came together, she was found to be with child through the Holy Spirit. Because Joseph, her husband, was a righteous man and did not want to expose her to the public disgrace, he had in mind to divorce her quietly. But after he had considered this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary home as your wife, because what is conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins." All this took place to fulfill what the Lord had said through the prophet, "The virgin will be with child and will give birth to a son, and they will call him Emmanuel," which means God with us.
Thank you.
My friends about the birth, but I just know I have to do this tonight. Maybe if I tell them that people came from far away and brought gifts to Jesus because he was important.
King Sir, we have a message.
Bring it to me. It seems we have some disturbance in the world tonight. Do any of you know about this?
No, sir, we do not.
You summon to me those visitors in my city and tell them I went to meet with them tonight.
Yes, sir.
Welcome, welcome. Would you like any of my ties for your travels?
No, sir. We have come looking for the new king. We all have seen his star and we like to bring him gifts and welcome him as the new king.
Yes, I have heard there has been a new king born. May I help you on your journey to find him by giving you 20% of my new line of ties that you inquire on your journey.
Thank you, sir. We'll text him when we're on our way so you can see him for yourself.
And on behalf of me and my kingdom, please take a new tie so you will look good on your journey, and please take one for the new king.
Thank you, sir, but we are ready for our own gifts.
This baby child is God. behind. We brought our best to celebrate a king who left his throne so he could be God with us, Emmanuel.
Lots of dirt on his face. And I have to just shake my head and laugh. I wonder what he'll be like when he grows up. Mary, you never had to wonder. You knew what your son was going to be, and you must have had a big heart, a broken but big heart, because you knew what was going to become of him.
My
They're part of the manger scene we keep on our fireplace.
Why would you do that? I don't get it.
Well, I told you guys to bring you a gift that costs a lot of money and makes you the happiest person in the world. This gift didn't cost any money, but it makes you the happiest person in the world.
Are you telling me these plastic people are going to make me happy?
Wait, are they like Transformers? Do they transform into something?
No, they're not Transformers, but one of them will transform your life.
That's just a red box. What's in it? $1 million? Is it a key to a Ferrari 58 Spider? That would make me the happiest person in the world.
No, it is the most valuable gift anyone ever gave, and if you have it, it will make you the happiest person on the world. But you have to first want it more than anything else on the world.
Nothing this small will make me this happy.
Come on, open the box and show us what it is.
Okay, but once I open it, you may never be the same. It was the greatest gift ever given, and people all over the world have allowed it to change their life and make them the most joyous they ever could be. Are you ready?
Thanks, guys. Why don't you guys all come up here?
Want to
cast one up here?
That's how we do it.
Excuse me, director. Excuse me.
Chris for all her hard work and putting this all together. And
Daddy,
I knew Chris, you didn't get blessed by that.
A little bit.
I don't know why, but thank you so much.
I enjoy doing this. I like writing for these guys. I like to write them because I can write them their parts. I mean, I've worked with them for the last couple years, and it's fun to know how to do this. And it's just great the way they learn their lines. And you know, we have the comedians, you know, like Brendan Green, who just carried that over so well as King Herod, you know, and the angels, you know, with their lights. That's just really good. I appreciate it. And, you know, I keep telling these guys, you know, next year you're gonna get bigger parts. Next year you're gonna get bigger parts.
Yeah.
You're gonna get it. Okay, all right. At this time, and you guys can go ahead and go. At this time, what we do every year is we take up what we call a Jesus birthday offering. And what we do is we help different things in the community. We help people within our church and things like that. And so, Harry, Dan, and thanks for these guys for leading us in our Christmas celebration too. So we appreciate it. So you can come up, and we're going to sing.
Yeah.
Come here. We're going to sing. I kind of threw this in at the last minute because I forgot.
You what?
Okay, we're going to do Away in a Manger.
Can I put
Away in a Manger, okay? So as we sing Away in a Manger, if you guys just want to come up and you know, for the offer plate. And then when you're done, thankfully from the Deborah Circle ladies, they made some cookies and we can have some lunch out there. So I really appreciate everybody being here. Before we go, if I can have let's just bow for a prayer. Our gracious Heavenly Father, I just thank you for the amazing gift that you gave us in your Son. God, I just thank you. I just thank you so much for the way that he touches all of our lives. God, I just ask that you be with us during this Christmas season, that as we experience opening our gifts this year, that we remember the most important gift that was given, and that was your Son, Jesus. We thank you, and we praise you for everything. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you.